In a sense, we are all migrants. The face of Australia is ever-changing. For some, that's something to be proud of. For others, it's not. It makes them uneasy, even fearful. But what about the migrants, the new arrivals? What do they make of Australia and Australians?
When they left Vietnam, they didn't have anything with them. You know, that was a huge risk they had to take, and I couldn't even imagine myself doing that now.
Tony Le-Nguyen remembers vividly his family's midnight escape from Vietnam 26 years on.
I heard machine guns, and there was just like people were shooting at us and they were shooting at the boat.
But the family of nine survived that attack by the communist regime and the refugee camps in Thailand and the long wait to be accepted by Australia.
When the plane arrived in Melbourne Airport for the first time, and it was really late at night, and I look out the window and it was like all these lights, you know, it's like glitter. It was just amazing, you know. And then we know that, you know, a place where we'll have a lot of opportunity to study and to learn, and the fact that we won't have to worry about whether we have enough food to eat.
Today, the family are reaping the rewards of hard work and study. Of the seven children, Tony's sister owns this Melbourne eatery. Another is a lawyer. There is a banker, a marketing specialist, a computer programmer, and Tony is a teacher and actor.
I think when I was much smaller, I see myself more Vietnamese. And then growing up in this country, I want to be more Australian. But I still love to connect with Vietnam. There are a lot of things that in Vietnam that I can learn and I can bring back to Australia to help, I can enhance this country, and I can make this country much more exciting. Even if we did put barbed wires around Australia, we won't be able to stop people from coming if the situation in their countries get worse.
10 years ago, the Toulba family fled Sudan. Today, they call this country home and themselves Aussies.
Yes, I'm now feeling as an Australian.
This is one of the few photos they have of their homeland. War was one of the reasons they escaped. The other was religious persecution.
I was in jail in Khartoum because they want to make me to shame myself to become a Muslim.
Mayhem's crime? He was a Christian, his wife a Muslim.
And when I came to Khartoum, the government said you cannot be with your wife unless to divorce her or you will be killed.
Relatives pulled strings to smuggle the family to Egypt. Then, 4 years ago, Australia accepted them.
It was a very, very exciting time because we have been living in this place uncertainty program, and we don't know where we can live or whether tomorrow we can be taken back to Sudan.
Today, Mayhem's five children are studying and have big plans.
I'd want to be a lawyer, a doctor.
I would like to be an engineer if I get into that.
I want to be a fashion designer or a GP or a lawyer. Yes.
I'd want to be an engineer, a doctor.
Each member of this family is now a proud Australian citizen.
I'm walking the street happy. I'm no different between me and you. You original Australia, but me, I'm Australian too, no problem.
Tony Yuen. No regrets? Life in Australia has been as you would hope?
No, I mean, life in Australia is great, but you know what I'm really saddened about it, we are not being honest tonight, because the majority of the illegal immigrants in this country are from UK, US and New Zealand.
Yeah.
They're not the people that we're trying to accuse of. That is the reality. That is the fact, you know, that I got from the Department of Immigration.
Can I go to Al Grasby, please? What has your observation been since you were the minister?
This debate has been permitted over the last 2 or 3 years to create great divisions and uncertainty among ordinary Australians. Yes. They are worried that they're going to be invaded. In a year that 400,000 refugees went into Europe, I think in that period we had 2,000. The problem is a small one. It doesn't deserve this sort of emotion or blaming of the victims.
I do not for a minute accuse the government of being racist, but what
they have happened, and I've seen it happening over the last 3 or 4 years, is they've played a very dangerous game. What they've done is unleashed in this country, for the first time that I can remember since living here and I was born here, a really dangerous race debate. They have played a very dangerous game. They will probably be elected as a result of what they've done with the Tampa, but they have unleashed something that is very dangerous. There is now virtually no difference in refugee policy between the Liberal Party and One Nation Party, and I think we are in very dangerous waters.
Every country in the world and the government of every country in the world has a legal and a moral right to protect its citizens. Now, we've had good comments on both sides here tonight, some not so good maybe in the eyes of others, but having that legal right means the government has to do something. And I would remind the people here of the RSL motto, eternal vigilance. We must have it, but we do not want to stop immigration.
Ian Rentoul, what sort of Australia do you want to see?
I think we need a multicultural Australia, and I don't think that's what the government is doing. The government is taking us back to a white Australia policy. That's what the legislation that they pushed through to Parliament with the shameful support of the Labor Party. That's where they want to take us. I don't think it's a legacy that the vast majority of Australians, when they know the situation, support at all.
What I think is a shame is that somehow we have started to talk in categories. We talk about refugees, we talk about asylum seekers and queue jumpers, and we forget the kind of young children that we've got here today who are the future of this country. And I want to ask the question, how are we all going to live together in this nation if we can't even listen to one another here tonight?
Mr. Ruddock, final words.
Well, let me just say that in relation to our multicultural society and its values, we promote them very strongly. And what we're seeking to do is to have a system in which we can focus on those with the greatest need for support. And that's what we will continue to do.
We'll have to leave it there. As we said at the beginning, this is a subject that generates a lot of passion, a lot of diverse opinions. Thanks for coming tonight. We'll be back with more of 60 Minutes in a moment.